Everybody, is Victor on Continuing Streak here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Afterbirth Plus series. The 6,000 like streak continues, as yesterday's video also crossing the 6,000 likes mark. I don't know how many videos that is in a row by now, but it's quite a bit. Thank you all very much for that. And not only did that happen, but the Ultra Hard Challenge is now approaching 11,000 likes as well. So if that one goes over 12,000, I will indeed keep on counting it. You guys and gals keep on liking that video, and I will keep on counting it as the milestones move up even further on that. Thank you all very much. Sincerely, it has been incredible to watch. Here's your meme of the day, brought to you by Dr. Strees, I think is the name. The title was, Feel Old Yet? Remember him? This is him now. Ah, yes, the DVD logo. I used to love, well, most of you probably, some of you may not know what that is, depending on how old you are, I guess. But I used to love watching the DVD screensavers there, because I was like, oh, look, this is the electronic boundaries that only exist in this world, and it's bound by that. Isn't that kind of cool? It's kind of neat. It bounces around. It's the size of my TV. I was kind of a nerd. I still am kind of a nerd. A nerd there. Thank you very much, Dr. Strees. Ooh, okay. See, today is going to be November 6, 9 Echo, 9 X-Ray, 4 Echo. We've got the D-Sizzle and Firemind. Hot bombs. No, matchbook. Not hot bombs. Matchbook. So luckily we did not get any troll bombs at the start. And the D sizzle is something that we haven't seen in quite a while. Also start off with a nickel as well. Oh my goodness. Well, I'm not gonna say no to that, especially considering that our starting damage is kind of doo doo. Need to be careful. These small skitterers here. They are considered champions. And with us not knowing exactly how much HP we have, even taking one hit of damage with Curse of the Unknown is kind of scary. So I have to unlock my mind in Isaac mode. I've been recording Pokemon today. We have three very solid episodes of Pokemon coming up for you. Okay, it's gonna be a dead end here. It's good. Good, good, good. So the D6 will reroll any pedestal item, and it's extremely good. For all stages of the game. So it doesn't matter if you're at the beginning of a run or at the end of a run, or in the middle, being able to reroll anything in the game, especially item pedestals, is extremely valuable. Because again, you can give value where there's none that actually existed beforehand. It looks like we're just going to go for the full clear here, and what can you do? I was really hoping there was going to be a Soul Heart in there. Without us knowing exactly how much HP we have, this is a rough call. Now, PhD early on wouldn't be terrible. I think we need to go for it. Let's use one bomb here. It was highly unlikely that we were going to be able to get a nickel out of there from that keeper. But what this does do is it gives us a little bit of a damage bonus here because of Money Equals Power, which is the reason why I felt okay doing that. We can safely assume the secret room is probably below this room here, but that's just an assumption. I need to go for confirmation on that. Or we can say the heck with that and just try to make the secret or the store work. Now the potential, because we ain't getting 7 cents off of our donation machine, brother. That's just not happening. I've never seen that happen unless you have Humbling Bundle or you have like an extended bomb, like a Bomber Boy or something like that. Secret room may also be there, actually. Let's see. No, I'm going to go here. Nickel? No, 2 cents. Not enough, unfortunately. We're 5 cents short, unless we get really lucky with Pageant Boy. Or we keep getting nickels here. Man, 4 cents in a dream. And no, I'm not considering playing the sacrifice room. By God, it's Pin. So unless we get either bombs here or we get money, we're not going to be able to get PH Dizzle early on, which is a little bit of a downer. But I think we all have seen how bad PhD can be when you don't have good pills. I mean, PhD is virtually worthless. It's not PhD's fault, of course. It's the game's fault. Range upgrade, no thank you. Movement speed upgrade, I mean, yes, there we go. That is the power of the D6, and that's exactly what I'm talking about. and Curse the Unknown again, which I am officially annoyed at now, because we don't know how much HP we have, which means that we don't know if we have Red Heart containers, we don't have swords, we don't know anything. We don't know anything about our HP. All that we know is that we're not on half of a heart. That's it. That's the literal only thing that we know. So until we can get at least one soul heart, I cannot safely take a devil deal at all, unless if it grants soul hearts or gives us an extra life. Outside of Guppy's tail, or Guppy's collar, I should say, because I'm not risking a 913 streak on Guppy's collar. No thanks. So money equals power, by the way. It will increase our damage based on how much money we're holding on to. So buying stuff early on with money equals power is a catch-22, or really not even early on, just any time with money equals power is a catch-22, because yes, you're getting stuff, but you're also, you know, you're also lowering the amount of damage you can do. Bozo, it's not a good item, but at least it gives us a slight damage upgrade, but more importantly, it gives us a soul heart upon acquiring it. I'm going to take a risk and open this golden chest here. It was a risk because obviously we could have gotten into the store, but now we have this golden key, and all we needed was one bomb, which is what I was kind of hoping for. So we just yeeted that golden key away here, but golden key is going to make it to where we don't have to worry about using keys on this floor, which is good because we have zero. So here's to hoping we find a bunch of like golden chests or something like that. Spider almost faked me out. See if we get around that. We get a Bomba as well. This is where damage is really important here. 5.43 damage. I mean, the synth oil acquisition was huge. Okay, so we know we've taken damage, and we couldn't pick up that red heart, which means that we are only on soul hearts, which means that we have to assume that we're only on, like, 2.5 at most. The absolute most, we're on 2.5 soul hearts currently. So if we can pick up, we would need to get a whole lot of soul hearts here in order for me to feel good about this. That was two. We need to get one more. Okay. I'm not going to be greedy. I'm going to play this safe because we want to take a devil deal. Especially with us having the D6, we want to be able to reroll that devil deal. Man, do I hate this room and I hate this fight. When Grub and Larry Jr. charge at the same time, it's bad news. But luckily, we got the charm thanks to Bozo. Okay, we get a Tears Up, which I will take. Two Soul Hearts. And then we get Guppy's Paw, Brother Bobby. So we actually do have a Red Heart. So that means that we started with at least one Red Heart and one Soul Heart. I can't play this Demon Judgment. I really can't. I know that I can tap him. I can tap him twice. That's it. I'm gonna take Guppy's Paw. Okay, we still have red hearts. We get Speedball. And use Guppy's Paw. Okay, so there goes all of our soul hearts, or all of our red hearts. I almost don't want Speedball because we're re-rolling inside of a devil deal room. I think this is ideal for us to get a re-roll. We get Lord of the Pit, we get Goathead, and we get Necronomicon. Now, I know that it may seem a little risky there with me taking the devil deal without knowing exactly how much HP we have, but remember we just used Guppy's Paw. So there really is no risk. There's no risk involved right there. We get one penny, which allows us to get into the arcade. I do want to go into the cursed room, though, despite us not having any bombs. Okay, this pays. We actually gain half of a soul heart here, so that's good. Good. So we end up getting flying. We end up getting Goathead, which will keep the deal with the devil open. And we can't do anything in here. So I was hoping I could re-roll Necronomicon, but we cannot. And 3 cents is all we need. I think we can get that 3 cents. That's the black. We only need to lose one soul heart. Yeah, because we bought two from the store, and then we also gained three with Guppy's paw. So right now we should, by the time we get to the next floor, we should have, I believe it's 1.5 soul hearts, I think. So let's see if that risk was worth it here. Oh, you better believe it was, Buster. What a play. Oh, wow. Yeah, we got plenty of HP. Never mind. We got plenty of HP. No problem. Again, showing you the power of the D-Sizzle. You love it. You love to see it. I know that some Spun fans out there will be sad that I passed up Speedball, but... Man, that was a very good play. That was a fantastic play to get Brimstone. I mean, I was happy with just re-rolling it just to get something out of that. I wasn't expecting it to be Brimstone, but hey, I'll freaking take it. And we got plenty of HP left over. We could have played that Demon Judgment even further. But again, without me, you can't blame me for being conservative and careful there. Because again, at the start of this run, we had no idea how much HP we had. We had no idea if we had good HP, bad HP. We had just literally none. Black Lotus. I am going to take Black Lotus here just because it gives us a Red Heart Container. I could have re-rolled that, but it's the regular Secret Room item pool. And it's probably going to end up being Missing No or something like that. This reroll is more valuable inside of our item room or the devil deal. Okay. Well, maybe. Oh, this is coming together real quick here. Ace of Diamonds. I'll go ahead and hold on to it. Quad shot Brimstone. Quad stone is in play here. And there are many possibilities where we can go from here. So many possibilities. Have to go through the big room, obviously. You tend to notice that the game loves to spawn boss rooms opposite of big rooms. Or at least they love to spawn special rooms opposite of big rooms. Just to make you go through there. So a full charge, ready to go for a reroll on the devil deal. We know we're going to get a devil deal because we have Goathead. We're definitely not going to reroll this orbital. So second book. I'll go ahead and take Book of Belial. It's an excellent item. Reroll. We get Spear of the Night, which we're one away from Leviathan now. The Curse of the Lost, unfortunately. Obviously, the Spectral Tears don't really mean anything for us since we have Brimstone. We have Piercing Spectral anyway. I am going to use the Ace of Diamonds in this room just because we have three empty chests and we can turn them into coins. But I'm not going to use it yet because we may be able to get more stuff on the ground first. Okay. Yeah, so I mean, 3 cents... It's 3 cents that we didn't have. It gives us a little bit of damage as well. Nothing wrong with that. Of course, Quad Shot Brimstone is extremely powerful. Even at low damage, in low damage situations like we're in right now, Quad Stone is still very, very, very good. I'm bombing these just for the moolah and the damage upgrade, of course. Tinted Rock up there. Ant says, nice rune, loser. Okay, I've got two bombs back in the key. I would have preferred Soul Heart, but what can you do? And a dead end. By the way, the trinket that we have is the AAA battery or trickle charge. And that will give us an occasional, I'm not sure if it's occasional or if it's guaranteed, extra charges every time we clear a room. See here, this damage that we got is just absolutely domination right now. It's so, you know, I was gonna do that. It's so awesome to see when you have a good Brimstone synergy that isn't like obscured by like a crazy tier effect, you know. There's Demon Baby, which I'm not gonna be taking. Sorry to comment, Bagel. She will be very upset. Now, if you're wondering how come I didn't re-roll, it's because we're saving this re-roll for the Devil Deal, which again is guaranteed. Didn't actually mean to buy that. I wanted to get this, wanted to get Tarot Cloth here, but I guess we're gonna have to wait for a moment. All right, so you're going to watch our damage go down after we pick up Tarot Cloth. Obviously, right now, I'm not going to pick up Tarot Cloth because I want to go fight the boss while we still have the damage bonus from our 15 cents. It may not be much, but remember, we have Brimstone, and damage scales extremely well with Brimstone. So there's no reason for us to handicap ourselves and force us to lose a lot of damage when we can just simply do that after the boss. We'll take Wooden Spoon. We need a movement speed up, and we get Maw of the freaking Void, which also gives Leviathan, I believe. Yep. So now we have Quad Shot, Brimstone, and Maw of the Void. That is a scary, scary amount of damage that we're able to do. And we also just got Tarot Cloth. Temperance Machine. We're ahead of the game. I'll at least buy this playing card to see what we got. Okay, there's IV bag. Two of diamonds. That's kind of what I was hoping for. Okay, so we're going to go down to... I'll go down to 2 HP. Okay, and then this is where we say goodbye to the Two of Diamonds. So we're going to use the Two of Diamonds twice. It's going to give us 60 cents out of this.
Two of Diamonds.
Because it doubles 15 first, which is 30, and then doubles that, which is 60. Okay. Mystery Gift I will take, and I will drop it in here just so we have an extra item pedestal to roll through. So now we have at least two. Starter deck is good enough for me to take. Get a Joker card. We get restock, and we also get a half price jumper cables. And we also got a golden heart as well, which is going to give us even more money here. Okay. And remember, we have restock now, so this is gonna maintain the we'll take IV bag and the D6, and we get fanny pack as well. Red Candida, it's not great. Two of Diamonds, however, is great. Yeah, I think we go down to 2 cents again. Is there any more hearts? First off, let's pick up the D6. Yeah, there we go. So we want hearts here. Thank you, Fanny Pack. That heart came from Fanny Pack, by the way. Okay, so that would give us only 32 cents. We need more than that, obviously. We want to get to 99 cents. We want to get to 99 cents, we have to get to at least 25 cents before using. Sun card will give us a full heal. It's a huge waste of a sun card, but not if it potentially leads us to getting 99 cents here with a half price premium item. So right now, all I'm doing is I'm just looking for red hearts on the ground. And yes, I am sad that we don't have Piggy Bank. If we had Piggy Bank, this game would have been broken already. And truth be told, we don't have to break the game here. In all honesty, I'm not trying to break the game right now. We've had broken runs already. But in this case, I think that if I can at least show you all how, like, just the little things matter. Just the little things. One cent here or there, and the next thing you know, you've got yourself a dominating position that you can be in order to just absolutely destroy the game with restock. So we can get down to, assume we don't get a dime or a nickel, we can get down to 1, 2, 3, 4. We can get to 60 cents again. Oh, never mind. That is beautiful.
Of diamonds.
Okay. And remember, we still have the D6. So we can, if we roll into blank card, it's over. Get Diplopia. There's the compass, which I'll happily take. Treasure map. So Diplopia plus the D6 will be a ton of items that we can roll through, and then it's just GG from there. Okay, we don't actually want car battery. For a reroll, we actually do not want car battery at all. So, this is a Joker card. Let's see if we can drop some money here. Oh, yeah. All right, so we're going to use Diplopia now. Yeah, that gives us a full charge on that. Might as well drop a trinket to see if we can get something lucky. Okay, now we're going to use the D6 to roll everything. Get Black Candle. Trinket Smelter, which is an excellent drop for us here. Deep Pockets. I don't really care about Deep Pockets, to be honest. Because we already have starter deck. I do want the blanket, however. Might as well use deck of cards here. Humbling Bundle, of course, is going to be nice with the IV bag. Ah, I didn't want the ladder. Okay, so I'm going to take Humbling Bundle. Pandora's Box. I do actually want the HP upgrade. Actually, no, I don't. I take that back. I don't. Okay, so we're going to reroll again. Blue map. I don't really care about the blue map, to be honest. We have map compass already. Hive Mind, car battery. There's PH Dizzle. More options. There's options. Chaos. I mean, chaos is a go at this point. I think we take chaos here, and that's all she wrote for this run. Again, I don't really want car battery if we're going to be re-rolling stuff. Ace reward, glitter bombs. I'm tired of seeing you, Explosive Ho. Okay, so we're going to re-roll this. We get Crown of Light, Forget Me Now. I don't think we need Forget Me Now. Okay, let's make some more. I know. I already see the comments coming up. Sinvicta says he's not going to break the game. Does it anyway? I mean, the opportunity presented itself. Come on now. Oh, we actually, because of Bozo, we got Unicorn Poop, so we get a full heal out of that. Not sure where those bombs came from. There we go. Oh, yeah, we have the Burnt Penny, that's why. Okay, well, I don't want the burnt penny anymore. Okay. I do want Vibrant Bulb. I will take Succubus. The others, I mean, we can leave them there. That's fine. Okay, we do get Sinvicta Robes and the Book of Revelations, which is going to give us Bookworm because we already had Necronomicon and Book of Belial. I'm not going to take Greed's Eye. So let's roll again. Get the Soul and Mr. Mega. And we also get Spun out of here. No, we don't get Spun. I take that back. Get Pyro, which is 99 bombs. So we're going through all the bomb upgrades, of course, as we do. Eye of Belial would have been great if we had, if we needed piercing shots, which we don't, of course. Shade, 9 lives. Book of Sin. Dark Prince's Crown, we don't have enough money for. Hold, please. Don't worry, we've got plenty of money. So the brimstone play getting a little outshined here by the broken run. Somehow we end up getting the burnt penny again. Get out of here. This Joker out of here. Hot bombs, fast bombs, scatter bombs, mom's coin purse. Remember we have PhD and we also have starter deck, Azlos coin, smart fly, and that gives us Guppy. Now, the only reason why I'm going through all of this stuff is just because we have the D6. The D6 makes this possible. D6 and Chaos, I should say. Didn't mean to reroll that. Ace of Diamonds. Sure.
Ace of Diamonds.
High Priestess. Don't really care about that. And what we're looking for now is just a half-price premium item. We accidentally hit the reroll machine. Penny sack, we don't really care about. Okay. Another Joker card. Alright, so this is probably where the break's going to end. And we get blank card. The virus. Now, the virus is spun, for sure. Fortunately, we don't have any hearts in here, but this is definitely spun. Okay. Alright, we'll use the D6 to roll here. I don't really care about blank card, to be honest. We don't need it. Oh my goodness. I mean, sure. Let's just get even crazier with our brimstone shots. Okay. Reroll this. I will take a tears up. Tears up. That blue cap will indeed break the tears cap as well. And we can afford a couple more rerolls here. Sacrificial Altar, which we don't have enough money for. So I'm going to have to buy the quarter just to get Sacrificial Altar here. Get Death Touch and Dark Bism. I don't really want Seraphim. I definitely don't want Keybegger. Roll it again. Let's try another roll. Guppy's Tail. I wouldn't mind taking Guppy's Tail because we can actually afford to take the chests here. Okay. All right. Well, I'd say that after all of that, it was probably worth it. A D6 breaking run is always fun. And now, I mean, we're firing out, assuming the Bookworm doesn't proc, we're firing, we're firing at the bare minimum, 7 brimstone tiers, or beams, I should say. And that's also not even including, you know, Maw of the Void. That right there is the only reason why I don't like scatter bombs. And yes, we do have glitter bombs, which means really it's not there. I'm surprised. We do have glitter bombs, which means we can get consumables from these bombs that drop, or that splinter off from scatter bombs. But it's usually not worth the trouble or hassle of trying to that's a level of min-maxing I'm not willing to do. I saw that dark bomb. Also remember, we are Guppy. We have Guppy Hive Mind, so our damage is going to be sick, nasty, crazy. That's two Dark Mum. Keeping tabs on you. Yeah, that is a good amount of damage here. With almost two rerolls, I'm gonna go into the Angel Room. And I am going to reroll this. Hermit card, Justice card. Now remember, we have chaos. Let's go get one more. Let's get one more charge here. There we go. We can take Cursed Eye because we have Black Candle. We don't have to worry about the teleportation effect. I don't think it actually does anything for Brimstone. We get Mama Mega, Dad's Key. Yeah, don't think we need either of those. Yeah, we don't need them. Because the strategy isn't going to be we're not going to give up the IV bag, because IV bag is just GG from here. I mean, this run's already a GG, of course, but. Okay. It's a lot of red hearts there, game. Is that back-to-back spiders? Dark Bum? Pretty sure I saw back-to-back spiders there. Okay, Explosive O and Contract from Below are two items I do not care about. Again, I'm not even using IV bag. We're just naturally getting money thanks to Mom's Key. This is a good amount of damage that we're doing. I would say it's adequate. It's okay. Okay, Transcendence here. What we're looking for right now is just. We're looking for items to pick up that give us damage, but we're also looking for a half-price premium item. No, half-price premium item. Yeah, but a half-price premium. I mean, half-price HP is okay, too. Half-price red hearts. But would be even better than that would just be a half-price premium item. There's the breakfast. We've reached breakfast levels already. Mama Mega. Well, I guess we can get into Boss Rush again and get Nun's Habit. Where's my half-price premium items at, though? They just don't exist anymore, huh? Okay. So we'll start buying item pedestal items here. Definitely going to take Sad Bombs for sure. And let's start re-rolling items. Okay. I think that's all I need to see there. We don't need any more than this. It's already ridiculous. We're already way out there GG. We're way out there GG-ified. So let's get Boss Rush out of here. Can we get back-to-back full house runs? That would be neat. All right, so we have Glyph of Balance and BBF, which I'm not going to entertain the thought of. Mama Mega unfortunately caused the Angel Statue to aggro, but that's okay. I don't think we've ever had back-to-back full house runs, come to think of it. Gotta say, I've been really loving watching my friend Chip, Jord, part of the Pokemon Den channel. Just watch them open Pokemon packs. It really, really gets me, like, interested and wanting to open more Pokemon cards, man. I don't know. I cannot describe why. I just love opening packs of cards. I think that's pretty much everybody. there's something magical about opening. Oh my goodness, that skeleton key. That is not a item that you see every single day. Like, just looking at the art and stuff, I just love them. I absolutely love Pokemon cards. And definitely, whenever things settle down for me, and I'm actually, like, you know, able to start saving money again, definitely going to start investing into Pokemon collecting. But not for, like, my own collections. Like, I would, like, I'm looking to, like, possibly, like, yeah, I treat them like stock. And that's the real draw for me is like, the ups and downs of, you know, of card values and stuff. But something I've talked about before, and yes, by the way, I should be picking up all this money because that's, we have money equals power. But something I've talked about before, and people in the know, the Mosh Pit especially, are way better in the know for this, is reselling Pokemon cards. Like, how does that, like, where do you sell them at? You know, I know that people are like, you know, well, you gotta get a local shop here. It's like, yeah, but there's no local shops down here that I think, they, like, all of them pay like a third of the cost of what they list for in the you know, on eBay or whatever. So finding a reputable vendor that's willing to pay a good price for the cards you get is, like, that seems to be one of the biggest challenges. But admittedly, I haven't looked that hard for them. I'm sure that there are a couple of good card shops down here. I just haven't found them yet. Because I would love to invest in some high dollar, like, Pokemon boxes, like, open them for a video and then, like, you know, try to turn a profit out of them or save them to see if they appreciate in value. I'm very profit minded when it comes to collecting cards. That same thing. I mean, same thing goes for video games too. Like, that's one thing I love about EVE Online is that you can, like, everything in Path of Exile as well. Everything in those games have value, and there's always a buyer's market. Like, there's always somebody out there who will buy it, no matter what you're selling. And I freaking love that. And if I could get that sort of level of commitment out of, like, Pokemon card investing, oh man, like, you guys and gals be seeing a lot of Pokemon pack openings. I don't know, man. I love cracking packs. It's just so much fun. And it's a community thing too. That's another thing. Like, who doesn't like? I mean, some people probably don't, but, like, who, for the majority, who doesn't like watching people just crack packs just to see what they get? You know. I mean, it's addicting. It really is. It's just as addicting as watching the person who's spending all the money opening the packs as it is just to see what they get as the audience. Victory lap is a go. Echo Alpha Delta Juliet Delta Zulu 4 Zulu. We have ourselves quite the start here. Back-to-back full house runs would be kind of neat, not going to lie. I'm going to take 9 lives again, just because. Why not? shade is kind of glitching out here. Just don't look directly into the shade. Okay, so I'm not going to stop in shops that don't have reroll machines just because it's just unnecessary. Remember, we have chaos, so chaos is going to change all of the loot tables no matter what we do. Get Eden's soul. Yeah. Eden's soul, Mama Mega, whatever. And we also have duality as well, which means that we will also get guaranteed angel deals, which is good. We have to sacrifice our first couple angel deals though for the key pieces. Fat Odd Mushroom, yeah, I'll go ahead and take that. I haven't seen Fat Odd Mushroom in a while. All right, so let's go get our key piece here. And we can still reroll. I'm not gonna take Mom's Eye. We can reroll these. We get Guppy's Head and Forget Me Now. Yeah. We can sacrifice some HP here to get a full charge with Nun's Habit, which is exactly what I did. Yeah, I'll take Rune Bag. Rune Bag's fine. That'd be cool. I think that would be great. If I had a if I could buy like a, you know, like a, I don't know, what's one of the mid-level Pokemon sets that collectors would want to invest in, like let's say 500 bucks for a box to start with. You know, that'd be great if I could get something like that and then be able to like turn it around and sell it to like a reputable vendor down here. That'd be cool. Coathead again. Okay, there's our half price premium item, but we don't want Greed's Gullet. We'll take the 9-volt. Book of Secrets. All we're looking for is spacebar. We're looking for spacebar items on the pedestal. That's all we're looking for here. Spacebar items. Okay, Guppy's Paw is a spacebar item. I will take Scapular just because Scapular is good. Just buying some more full charges here. Void and Death List. I don't really want Death List. I will take a Tears upgrade here with a Torn Photo. Not that it did anything. Again, all I'm doing here is just making money so we can buy full charges to roll with a D6. That's the only thing I'm doing here. Yeah, we do not want to lose the IV bag. Thank you very much. I'll just take Void's Invicta. Nah, we don't want it. We'll take Growth Hormones. We get Unicorn Stump. Again, we're just looking for good damage upgrades, and we're looking for spacebar item pedestals that we can roll with the D-Sizzle. Sad Bombs we already have. Magic Mush, now we're talking, Coach. And there it is. There's the ultimate prize that I was looking for. I didn't want to say it because I didn't want to jinx it, but there it is. We are done, Dizzle. Team Carry Cat, where are you at? Yeah, this is all kinds of GG here. I think we still need one more key piece, which we do. I don't care if we get Curse the Tower at this point. Doesn't matter. We got Team Carry Cat. We're gunning for that full house clear here. Yeah, Tammy's Head Brimstone, absolutely the number one hard carry item combo in the entire game. Entire game. It does not get any better or faster in terms of like room clearing ability than Tammy's Head Brimstone. Oh my goodness, we get the pact again. And because we're on a victory lap, I'm unable to actually donate anything, so there's no reason for us to go into the stores anymore. And, sure. Eh. Oh my goodness. Now we're starting to get into some crazy town territory of damage here. Yeah, so this is what I'm talking about. We're just walking through these rooms here. If we get hit, who cares? Not us, because we got plenty of HP to work with. Ace of Diamonds. Golden Teleporter. Eh. Just looking for extra item pedestals here. We didn't get any, so. Mama Mega again. Now I could have used the Crooked Penny there as well, but obviously we don't care. We are just rolling. 31.69 damage is just so good. Take Tarot Claws just so it stops showing up. Over here, doesn't really matter. Are any of you out there avid Pokemon card collectors? Let me know in the comments. I've done a couple of Pokemon box openings that are actually on this YouTube channel as well. And I think that I would put the Pokemon box openings on this channel as well. I wouldn't make a second channel for it. Let me know if you collect Pokemon cards. I'd love to hear from you. So I'm actually going to take Mom's contact here because we want to have the reroll for the boss rush here. It's not ideal, but I guess I'll take the Bibble only because I don't want to see it again. That also looked glitchy as all heck. Yeah, we're doing pretty good damage here, I'd say. Okay. Leave it to Haunt. Like, what are some of the mid tier box sets that a beginner Pokemon card investor would want to look at? Unbroken Bonds. Something older than that. People talk about Shadowless cards. I don't even know what Shadowless is. I assume it's for like the actual print of the card itself. I'll take Toothpicks. And we'll take the Mark as well. And what a powerhouse run this turned out to be. For a non-broken run, this run turned out to be very broken. This is what I'm talking about with the clearing speed of Tammy's Head Brimstone is just unmatched. Absolutely unmatched. Oh, okay, we're just gonna get pushed out of the room, I guess. Because that's something that can happen, apparently. No. Nope. There's no reason for us to take soy milk here. In fact, there's no reason for us to even fight Fight the angel statue. I just go to 20 lives. You know, it's you can never be too sure. Oh, this is a short trip over here. So at the end of the day, this run was a lot of fun. Hopefully you all enjoyed it. And we're getting very close now to finding out if we're... This is what I'm talking about. Although, Steven's a pretty big upgrade. Let's roll the dice. Let's roll it. Okay, let's try that again. We need to hit ourselves. There we go. Could go to the sacrifice room as well. I'm just looking for rerolls. Since we have a quad, since we have a quadruple item pedestal here, that's all I want. There we go. I won't come back after this, I promise. All right, let's see what we get. I will take Bomber Boy here because Bomber Boy is going to be very useful against Hush. Old Hushy is here. He hears us coming down here. He's like, oh God, not again, please. Guppy's tail for like the 10th time. All right, I'll take Guppy's tail only just to make it stop from appearing again. Take butt bombs here. Is that a golden bomb I see? Oh, it is. Oh, lordy. All right, well, let's see what happens to Hush here. I'd say that worked out pretty well. Not too shabby. Like I said, Sad Bombs and Bomber Boy will tear up any boss, including Delirium and Old Hushy. Oh, that was satisfying. You heard the clown shoe squeak there. That was from us getting hit. And I think dropping a unicorn poop. So, again, with yesterday's run, you already know that we're going to be able to take Blue Babby. Let's go fight him real quick just to see if we get the portal. You know that we're also going to be able to beat Mega Stanley as well, so... The idea here is that we're trying to get to Delirium.
Well, you could have just gone after Hush and Victor.
Yeah, but if I went after Hush, then we would not have gotten Isaac either, which is... I would say Isaac is kind of, you know, a big deal if you want to consider yourself doing a full house run. We did get the portal, so we're going to head on down to Delirium. Megastan is the lucky one, but you already know that we could have absolutely crushed him. My God, it's pin. Lots of pins. Here we go. And that's how you beat Delirium. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this episode of The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. What a broken run it turned out to be. And it was all thanks to that one IV bag play. If you enjoyed this video, can we keep the 6,000 like streak going? Can we get another video that has 10,000 likes? I don't even freaking know, dude. The Mosh Pit is crazy and awesome. And I cannot thank you all enough for that. So I hope you had a great start to your Fridays here. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. I hope your Friday gets better. Check out Pokemon coming up later on tonight as the final episode with Ryan and GeoGuessr for a little bit before we start having a rotating guest panel of co-hosts with me. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Alex Ackham, Todd, Elogia, and Jose Gomez. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of every episode here at The Binding of Isaac, then check out my Patreon over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.